Fuka, that's her name. That's her mom. Oh, wait, what? Okaimono itte kureru? So I understand every word. I just want to piece it correctly together. So, oh, that's just, I still don't know when, if it's like just some used. So before some nouns, you just put oh. And for example, okane, ohashi, okaimono. And I'm not sure if it's just like fixed words where it is used or if it has some other meaning, because it was explained to me that it's just something left from old Japanese and it's some honorific for the noun, but I'm definitely like not sure if that is really the case. So okaimono. Kaimono is shopping. I guess. Yeah. Itte kureru. Kure. So, itte is the form of iru, which is go, kureru. So, kuru, or is it kureru? Do for someone. Or is it this passive of kuru? I'm confused now. So basically, she's asking, could you go and do shopping? Will you run to the store for me? Yeah. Okay, let's just delve deeper. Okay, so kureru, to do for one. Kureru. And kuru is just do something. Kuru, no, not this kuru. You see? To give, to let one have, to do for one. Oh, it's archaism. No, I'm just mistaking it with... No. I mean kururu. It's just one word. There's no other one. It's kuru. It's to come. Or to come back. Do and come back, yeah. Or it's kururu. But... what are the forms? Kurenai, kureta, れました。Because what is like in my mind is that in anime they shorten it a lot to kure, but yeah, that's like Whatever. I'm not going to be exploring it. Isn't it like a proposal? If you say just kure, I don't know. Whatever. So potential would be, oh wait, this is not my verb to get dark. This is my verb, but I guess it has the same inflections. Kureられる kureられる kureられる. Alright, so I understood this. Yes. Okaimono itte kureru. Iyo. Nani kau no? So, huh? Sure. Or it's all right. Nani kau no. Like what? Kau by no. I don't think it's nominalization. Nani kau no. I don't really know what the no in the on the at the end is. Nani kau no. So what should I buy? Sure thing. What do you need me to buy? Indicates possessive. Confident conclusion. So just indicates question. I know that it is used with some questions. For example, Nanika Tano. But But isn't the no substitute for, in that sentence, 何かあったの?何かあった、いった、no. Eh, whatever. I'll get it someday later. Butsu dan. Isn't it Budan? Butsudan. Butsudan no Ohana. So, I don't know what Butsudan is, but Hana is a flower. Butsudan no Ohana. Butsudan no Ohana. So flowery. What? Buddhist. Butsudan. Butsudan.
Butsudan.
My God, that was loud.
Butsudan.
Butsudan. Butsudan. Butsudan. Butsudan. Butsudan. Butsudan. Butsudan no Ohana. So Buddhist flower. Buddhist blossom. Huh. Oh. I'm just trying to figure out if it's like name of a flower, or is it just flower? For the shrine. Oh, Buddhist altar. Buddhist altar flower. So, yeah, so is it specific flower, or is it just anything? I guess it's anything. And it's not like type specific. All right. Butsudan no Ohana. Wakatta. Understood. Got it. Yosh. Ja. Kyo. No. Tokun. Owari. So I'm guessing the last words but I've heard it before. Is it going to be like finished? So, yosh, well. Or yosh, very well. So, kyo, today. Kyo, no. So that's today's dokkun intensive training. Owari is finished. Maybe. That's it for today's training. Owari, the end. Noun. Owaru. To finish, to end, to close. Owaru. Owaru. To finish, to end, to close. Owari. The end. My today's training session is over. And Dokkun, yeah, that's the intensive training. All right. I understood another sentence fully, although I guessed the last word. Yoshi, ja, kyō no Dokkun. Owari. Although, if furigana was missing, I wouldn't recognize that Owari. No, sorry, Dokkun Owari. Arigato gozaimashita. Thank you very much. Arigato gozaimashita. Arigato gozaimashita. Thank you for teaching me. Oh, thank you very much. Sensei.